Hello YouTube! So today, we are reviewing a player who has made it from Iron to Radiant within the span of 74 hours. The man's name is Root. He's trying to hit 50k subs by the end of the year, so go subscribe to him, Insane Content Creator, Insane Player. Yeah, we're looking at his gameplay today. Anyway, if you guys want to see this stuff live, come on over to twitch.tv/eggwick, and if you do enjoy the content, please consider subscribing to the YouTube channel. Mr. Root over here, the Valorant world record for hitting Radiant in the shortest amount of time possible from Iron.
I got you.
Give me those back.
He wants it.
Hey guys, in this video, we are going to be taking an Iron account to Radiant in 74 hours of playtime. If you like these types of videos, I stream every day at twitch.tv/root.
Okay, I know everyone's gonna say it already, but I know Timmy did something similar, I think. And from what I know, Timmy did that in a longer time frame. And I think he also didn't hit Radiant, right? Which means it's a different challenge. Why do you always run out of breath in doing your intro? You mean touch grass in 74 hours? All right. So our first clips here are in Iron.
One enemy remaining.
Real quick though, before the video starts, did anyone see this? Look at this. Is this a common occurrence in Iron where people are just staring at the wall? There are like two players here who are just staring at the wall. Look at the jet.
Three subs.
Look at the broom.
One enemy remaining.
They're AFK? Holy f- he has 31 and 2? Well, I think he's gonna get a double rank up anyway. He should be getting out of Iron in like 2 or 3 games. Dude, look! Wait, is that AFK or are those like bots that are just made to make low account- Wait, bots? Valorant has bots? No, because if they're AFK, they would have despawned already. This is the first time I've ever seen this. Like, I know that there are bots sometimes in Unrated where they just spin around in a circle, but these are W key bots? Oh, actually, to be fair, this is probably easier to code than, I guess, but still.
Fade hit for 99.
Last player standing. One
I kind of feel bad for the three other players who are actually trying to win, mainly because it's not their fault. Like, you have two bots on your team? Feels bad?
Another ace. Okay.
Then again.
Defenders win.
His teammate dropped 22 though. Dropped a 40. Oh, look, they are bots. Look at that. And they're on 100 ping too. This is really interesting, actually. Maybe we should do like a deep dive into like the weird sides of Valorant. But still, that's kind of crazy. 200 ping, W key Andes, both in Iron 1.
Meant for this climate.
So I guess this is the second game. Wait, before anything, chat, how many games do you think it'll take him to hit Radiant? Because we're seeing him, he won his first game in Iron 1. He's 1-0. I'm assuming that he wins most of his games up until the diamond section. Diamond rank? More than... Okay. Keep it coming. 45. 100 plus. Wait, is it really going to be 100 plus? Let's assume that from Iron, he gets double rank ups. So Iron 1 to Iron 3, that's probably like 4 games. Iron 3 to Silver 2, that's probably another 4. I'm guessing maybe around like 70, 80 games? No, but the Radiant portion will be hard. I actually wonder, like, how much time he spends in the low ranks, because I feel like he'll hit a roadblock when it comes to like Immortal gameplay. I feel like Immortal gameplay might be even like half the entire speedrun. Because this just looks... Wait, I just realized he's... Was he losing? I just realized he's popping off for his team, but he is actually losing 4-6. See chat, teamwork makes the dream work, man. His breach was throwing. Yeah, I guess when you're playing in these ranks though, and you're of like a much higher skill level. Oh my god, that's a 50 bomb. Like a much higher skill level. I guess Reyna is probably your best pick. Okay, see, yeah. So he's already hit Iron 3, but it took him, you guys can't see it very clearly, but it's up here if you see that. It's 4 wins and 0 losses to hit Iron 3. So I'm assuming that he ranks up twice every 4 wins, assuming that they're all wins and he hasn't lost. So if someone's good at math here...
we're missing the rank. Can you clean up after us?
Off your feet!
I'd say an average of 20 per game. Every rank is 300. Well, you mean 100. Wait, is every rank 300 RR? Oh yeah, no, it is 300 RR. You're right. No, but he'll skip. So technically a rank is... I don't know.
Just short.
Jesus, man.
Okay, we're bronze too.
Okay, yeah. See, so it's a double rank up anyway. This Haley guy is cracked. Hey, nosy.
I have a band of voice. No, not.
Oh, no. Little sussy.
Shoot your shot, bro.
I ain't shooting no shot, bro. Fuck that. I'm just here to get carried.
The ghost and... Oh, I'm surprised he bought a flash. Like, look at this. So he's playing through bronze, right? I'm assuming if you're a higher ranked player and you're playing in bronze, I don't think you're gonna buy a flash, but he surprisingly bought one. I would have went for, like, the double suck just in case I get shot because my life, it's so much more valuable compared to everyone else. But that's also true. Someone says in chat that there are comms now. It's like we're taking a trip through the ranks of Valorant. Stealing sets. Iron had zero comms. Bronze has comms now?
Haley? Are you good?
Bro? Holy fuck, what is going
bro,
on?
Bro, I didn't even see it. Fire in the
hole! You motherfucker. You motherfucker.
Wait, you little
It's really fucking funny too because there's no raise on the team. There isn't a raise on the enemy team. Dude, I remember when this was a thing. Like, people would troll and stuff and oh man.
Have a raise!
Okay, double rank up to silver now. Oh! Wait, chat, do you see this? He lost once. 12 wins, 1 loss, and he's silver 3 now. It is possible to beat players who are a much higher rank than you. Just go work together, chat, you know? I wonder if someone can actually do, like, a lossless run. Oh, God. But that'd be insane. It's like those Elden Ring speedruns where they don't die. Or Minecraft speedruns. Actually, no, that's different, because if you don't die on a speedrun, that's too much. That's actually impossible. Wait, this is such a close game. Oh my god. 15-13 in silver. I really want to ask him, though, which rank gave him the hardest time? Because it feels like bronze and iron weren't too much of a struggle, but it seems like there's a bit more struggle in silver, though he did lose one game in bronze. I don't know. I mean, Immo is for sure harder, but just from, like, iron to diamond or somewhere there. He's not even top frag this game. Look at this, chat. His jet's top fragging, which is cool. I mean, it happens. I bet silver gave him problems.
Oh my god. These games are more exciting than VCT, I swear to god. Give me the diamond one, give me the plat one, give me the gold three.
Wait! He's in silver three, but he's getting like diamond and plat enemies. Well, I guess the game is already... So there's this thing in League of Legends called a Smurf queue. And I don't know if they implemented it in Valorant, but Smurf queue in League of Legends means that if the game detects that you're a Smurf, they're gonna put you in higher lobbies so that your MMR adjusts your rank adjusts faster. Which means that if you win games, you'll get more RR, and if you lose games, you'll get less deduction of RR. So even if he's a silver 3 player, his MMR is high enough that he's playing with platinum diamond players. Maybe this is what's happening. That's MMR, not Smurf Q. Oh, I see. Maybe I'm confusing the two.
Oh my god.
Woo! Oh, he's gold now. 16 wins, 1 loss. What? That bronze game really tainted his record. Imagine. Side note, chat, but I really like this guy's name. I don't know why, but NA players really have the best names. The top frag or the, the chamber top frag on the enemy team is called Grumpy. Like, what the fuck is that? That's a great name.
Okay. Dash?
Oh, he's playing jet now. I just realized that. He hit gold and he's starting to play Jett instead of Reyna. Or maybe just this game. Because someone else got Reyna. Wait, wait. We gotta go back to the names, Jett. These are amazing names. I saw a little glimpse there. We got Willy Squirts 69, Coochie Milks 2K, and this game sucks. NA players, man. NA is wild, man. It's just great. And we have Radiant Smurf with one kill. How ironic. Oh, he's flat now. Okay.
Fuck, dude.
One enemy remaining.
19 wins and one loss in flat.
Bring one shot.
One enemy remaining.
It looks like the games are getting a lot closer, though.
Yeah, those are diamonds. Poor diamonds.
Oh my. Yeah, poor. Holy shit. The only plat player in the diamond lobby.
105, 105. Chamber.
You know, I always get these comments on the subreddit about how, like, oh, I got placed in a way higher game. So doesn't that mean it's a good thing then? That you got placed in a rank, or you're playing in a rank, even though you're a low rank, you're playing in a rank that's way higher than you? Because doesn't that mean that the game marked you off as a good player, or your MMR is good? So I don't know why people are complaining. No, you lose the same amount of MMR? Really?
Enemy remaining.
105.
Oh, also he has two losses now. Look at this, chat. He's plat 3 now and he has two losses. So he got one loss in bronze and he got one loss in plat.
One enemy remaining. Somebody is either... You're crazy,
Jet. Oh, Jet, you're insane, man.
I really want to see, like, the stats after this. Like, I wonder what... See, chat, it happens to even the best players, man. But I really, honestly, I want to see, like, what his stats are. I wonder what the KD is like.
Okay, why is my guy on YouTube guy? Give me a second.
Spike planted.
Oh, he's diamond already.
Got him.
Oh, underneath the...
Last player standing.
Yellow.
One enemy remaining.
You know, maybe I'm just, like, washed up or something, but for some reason, this, like, I don't know why, but the plat games look harder than the diamond games. I don't know.
You're so good.
Probably just me.
Last player
standing.
As at the beginning of the stream, I asked, he was the first person to put it. Yeah, what's up, dude?
Plat games are highly inconsistent.
No way.
What's up?
No way.
Wait, what's going on?
What happened?
How did you get the diamond one so fast?
Wait, is someone...
a mouse there.
Like, oh. Oh, no, that was someone in his party.
Enemy kill, one enemy remaining.
Damn. 25 games already. He's already diamond one. That's 17 and 5. Jesus Christ. Diamond 3 now. Oh, chat. I wish, you know what I wish? I really wish we could have seen the losses too. Like, it's really cool. Maybe a longer video would have been nice. But if you see here, he's 37 wins and 5 losses already, which means he lost 3 times in diamond. 37. But it would be a lot longer video if he showed everything. Okay. No, holy shit. Wait! It's still on 35 and 5. Does it mean that he drew this game? Do people draw in diamond? Wait, what? Wait, I'm confused. It went back to 35. It was on 37. Maybe this isn't, like, chronological? Or maybe the, the clips were just switched. Yeah, probably the clips were switched. The editor messed up. Okay, so we're ascended now. 40 and 5. So he did switch to Jett. I think after hitting, like, silver or something, he switched to... Switch from Jett to Reyna. I mean, Reyna to Jett. That's kind of sick. Holy shit.
They know.
That's some clean aim. It was a repeat. Ooh. Ooh.
Spike down.
One screen.
Three. Last player standing. One enemy remaining.
Down.
Another fucking
down.
Thanks for my 20 assists.
You know, I just realized too, as we progress through the ranks, you can see that starting like Ascendant and Diamond, players tend to like try to trade off each other. When you look at like the Iron Clips, everyone's just so far from each other and no one's like playing together. But this makes the clip like so much better. Wait, 9 losses now. Oh, I just realized that too. So 53 and 9. That's 4 more losses in Ascendant. 62 matches already. Bro, in silver, people say you're baiting if you trade them. Skill issue. Ooh! Oh my god. I'm so sad about the Fade nerfs, by the way. Fade was so fun to play. It's a big feels bad, okay?
81 on Jet, last 2 there.
Actually, no, I think
I can
do it.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I don't know.
Holy fuck. It's a human highlight reel. Jesus. And Iron teammates don't care. Everyone for themselves. Yeah. I see. Oh, wait. What the hell? He hit Immortal already. He has a total of 72 games, 61 wins, 11 losses. I don't know where the 2 losses came from. Probably Ascendant. But I'm guessing this is where he gets hard stuff now. Could you imagine, though, if he had a harder time and, like, flat compared to Immortal? Play.
I was VP! For their pushing. Maybe I'll find. Get out of my way! They seem to be.
65-13 now. There. Yeah, you're right. Oh, yeah, he is playing Phoenix now.
One enemy remaining.
Down!
Face your fear!
Back to Jet again. Oh, this is scary, but the man is insane. Wait, did you guys see the Sage? Look at that. Just popped out for a little bit with a knife out, like, hello? My guy? Are we not gonna shoot? Look! Look!
Bruh.
Doesn't even have her gun out! What the fuck is going on?
One enemy remaining. Get out of my way!
Oh, shit. Got blocked by his teammate, too.
Down A.
That happens a lot. Oh. I was gonna say that happens a lot more often than you think. Down, this man is sick.
We need what? 360 elo? It's doable.
I can flash.
Alright, did someone say 100 plus? Because he's about to go hit 100 plus games.
He has ult.
Damn,
I know a lot of people were saying like below 100.
For the rest of us, it's supposed to be 1 each. What are you doing?
Get out of my way!
I said 100 plus. Okay. 80. Oh, he's 100 now. Yeah, and Immortal too. So 100 plus for sure.
Oh, he's pushing with a dodge.
Oh. 2 on B. We should go A.
Immortal too.
Okay, I'll get B.
His MMR must be off the charts? Yeah, most likely.
One enemy remaining.
I mean, look at that win rate. Can someone like calculate the win rate on this account? Because that's insane. 72 to 17? That's like what? A 70% win rate or something?
One enemy remaining.
80?
Oh
my god.
Back out. It's a smoke.
Around 79. Yeah, that is insane. Inside.
Fucking Mando Major going 6-23.
Oh,
fucking
and he Reno. Calls out people too.
Money at down mid, 2 seconds in the round. Look, wait, guys, check this out, ready? 2 seconds, he's running down mid. 4 seconds, he's running down mid. 14 seconds.
Down. That's just unfortunate. Nothing you can do about that, really.
Three.
Man has crispy aim, though. Is this a Radiant rank up? Oh man. I thought that was it.
How'd I get my one Reyna? Reyna.
One enemy remaining.
Oh my god. Okay, so we're at almost...
One, bro, Fucking Reyna,
we're at like 110 games ish somewhere there.
Just shield. Don't push it. You have a shotgun. We're short, guys. Short.
That's blank. Crazy. No charges left. Who do you think's the most impactful agent, chat? Because I know a lot of Smurfs will play Reyna or Jett, but in a fair setting, is it still Reyna and Jett? That's the question, because if you're a better aimer, a better player, then obviously playing duelists will give you a better chance at having like a high impact. But if everyone's around the same level, then who has the most consistent value? Because your duelists can sometimes not perform too. And when everything depends on your aim, and aim is, maybe your aim's not too good on a certain day or something like that, your value as a duelist goes down a bit. Is it Chamber? I mean, Chamber just has so much too. Chamber has a jet dash. Chamber has a trip. I don't know, man.
He didn't flank. Give him back, in.
Okay. I'm holding the option.
BBB. You should see your
faces. It's near 130 games, I'm telling you. I mean, he it's already like 131 games.
Three. What?
Oh, he's doing this in Immortal? Damn! I mean, it just kind of shows the level between like the top 500 and the rest of Immortal. I feel like if you're a low Immortal like me, playing against like higher Immortals, it's just a totally different experience. The rank difference is so big.
Oh, one more.
Or the skill difference, I mean.
Jared.
Oh my god, we did it. Oh my god, we did it. Oh my god.
Wait, did he hit it?
The right click for the win.
He hit it on 139 games?
Oh, he wins that lobby though. Plus 13 for that rank up.
Holy.
We finally finished this challenge. It took me 110 wins. I think the losses are at like 28.
Holy.
I think it was like 2 additional or something. This account was Iron 1 like 10 days ago. It's like 110 wins, 28 losses. I think that's the final stats.
Holy crap. Oh my god, we went into a Minecraft vid. Wait, holy crap though. Imagine going from Iron to Immortal to Radiant in a single week. That's crazy. That's good stuff. Guys, go subscribe to Root. He's trying to hit 50k by end of the year. Matt's an insane gamer. But that is crazy. I wonder how many games he played per day. Damn.